Today on The Lab, I'm going to show you how to save money. I'm Johnny Jett. Hey, how are you? Good to see you, and welcome. It's time for The Lab with Leo. I'm Leo, and this is a show where we're going to help you understand technology, how it works, how you can have fun with it, and how you can get rid of it when you're done with it. Ladies and gentlemen, Kate Abraham, where she's a keeper. We're keeping her. She answers all your calls, gets some great callers for the show today, right?
We have some really great callers today. We really do.
Good. And may I see the clipboard?
Yes, you may.
This would be episode 16, it says right here. See, without the... Not, 19? Oh, I'm sorry. 19. There it is. I had it upside down. That's all. It's that guy in there that did it wrong. And but now I have to turn it right side up again to read. Oh, Johnny Jett. We saw Johnny Jett. He is our king of cheap airfare. He's going to show us how to travel internationally on the cheap, something you do a lot
yes,
of.
Yes, I do. I mean, obviously, you get back to England about twice a year. So.
Really? Oh, that often?
Mum calls me back in.
Do you do that just to keep your accent?
I can't lose it.
It's quite adorable. Why lose it?
It's so hammy.
You don't want to sound like me, do you? Yeah, I don't think so.
I'm trying to lose it.
If I could sound like you, I would.
We should swap accents for an episode. See how we get on.
There's got to be a powder. Coming up in just a little bit. Do you like to fly? Do you like to travel? Do you want to save money? Of course you do. Johnny Jett's here. He's going to show us how to do all of the above. You stay right here. Welcome back to The Lab with Leo. One of my favorite guests is on with us now. He just spent the last month traveling 30,000 air miles. Last year, 22 countries and 5 continents. According to Outside Magazine, he has a dream job. Johnny Jett, it says right here, has a 3-star on the Dream-O-Meter. That means a gig to die for. He gets to travel all around the world, searching out great travel deals for you and then putting them on his website at johnnyjett.com. Johnny's here. Let's say hello, ladies and gentlemen, to Johnny Jett. Good to have you back. Welcome. Sit down. Let's talk travel.
All right.
You just got back from Rio.
I did.
Oh, man.
And Cyprus. And London.
That's how you put up 30,000 miles.
Yeah.
Wow. Do you get sick of sitting on a plane after a while?
I don't.
You don't mind?
No. I go to different websites, find the best seat. Talk to the flight attendants, the gate agents, try to get upgraded.
See, this is your dream job.
Of course.
And it's all research. That's the beauty of it.
It is. Always bring a box of chocolates with you.
Oh, who's that for?
The gate agents. Get you upgraded.
I'm going to remember that. Very important. Really? Does that work?
Sometimes.
Don't they see through
sometimes.
That?
Sometimes.
Not with that smile. See, he gives them the Johnny Jett smile. That's what does it. So today we're going to talk about international travel. Let's say you're like Kate. You want to go back to England or you're looking for somewhere to go. How do we get the best deals?
I actually just found her a deal just now waiting.
This is what I love. First of all, always go to johnnyjett.com.
Of course, go to johnnyjett.com, sign up for our free weekly newsletter. You do it right in there.
Since 1999, you've been doing this. I mean, you really have a great database of deals and how to find the best airfare and things like travel, you know, finding the best seats, talking to the gate agent, stuff like that.
Little tips. But another website you should sign up for or newsletter is airfarewatchdog.com.
Okay.
So what they do is they alert you whenever there's a deal. So I was just looking right now. There's a deal from Toronto to Manchester, UK for $364 round trip, including all taxes.
That's a pretty good price, isn't it, Kate? $364? That's really good.
That's insane.
Now, is that because you have to be able to drop out of everything and travel? I mean, is flexibility...
Well, I just look. This one has certain dates. Yeah. But others, you know, you never know. There's other deals to... there's another one to London for $529. So all depends on the carrier and the dates.
And whether you want to fly to Manchester. Yeah. Which isn't bad,
but
I'm just saying.
They also have Fort Lauderdale for $178 round trip.
Wow, so that's cool.
It's a good weekend escape.
So you told me that you are planning a trip to Europe in the near future. And you want to go from where? From Nice to Rome?
Yes. I'm going to be in Nice.
Some people. What a tough life.
So I logged on to the search engines. And it came out for one-way ticket on the big carrier, $729.
$729.
For a one-way ticket. And I was like, that's ridiculous.
Yeah.
So I put in a round trip, which is old-school thinking, because in Europe...
It should cost twice as much, right?
Yeah, but it costs $220.
What?
Yeah.
So somehow their computers are messed up, but
that's just the old way of pricing out airfares.
It's cheaper if it's round trip.
And you throw away the return ticket.
Oh, you don't take that second
No,
flight.
But don't tell them I told you that because it's against airline policy and they can take away your miles.
They may not like it that you did that.
They don't like that.
Okay.
Because it's kind of beating it. But I still wasn't happy with the 220.
You want cheaper than
I
that?
I want cheaper.
All right.
So I went to whichbudget.com, W-H-I-C-H, budget.com. These guys have 115 airlines, all budget, in 120 countries.
That's a new thing, isn't it? All these very, well, not new necessarily, but there's a lot of low-price airlines.
Oh, for sure. They're always popping up.
Yeah.
So I put in, I want to fly from France, and then I go to Nice. Then it comes up, and it'll show you all your different options.
They don't spend a lot of money on the website, do they?
No.
That's all right.
The website is budget.
Which budget? We're looking for a good deal.
So I want to go to Italy. So Rome, there's Blue Express. And I bought this a couple days ago. I got it for €49.
Oh, that's a lot.
Which is $66.
Less. That's incredible.
U.S.
Compared to $729. So now here's a question. How do you know about that airline? Is it an okay airline? What do we do?
Well, before I booked it, I did some research. And Blue Express is a brand new airline, but they fly all new 737s.
Okay. You got to be careful on these new airlines because they come and go.
They do. And you don't. That's why you don't want to book too far in advance.
Right. Right. Make sure they're still in business by the time you fly. All right. What other tips do you have for us?
Okay. Let's say you're going to go international. Instead of just flying from here to Australia, you might want to do a round-the-world ticket.
Look at this. This is so cool. Beautiful site. Trip Planner, huh?
Yep. This is by Airtrex.com.
Okay.
So I put in most of the legs. I went from Vancouver to New York, Paris, Bangkok, Sydney. Now I'm going to put in, let's do Hawaii and then finish it up in Vancouver.
Are you doing a round-the-world
trip?
Round-the-world
ticket. You could never do this a few years ago. Thanks to the internet.
And it's different carriers and everything, right? I mean, it couldn't all be the same carrier.
They'll be different carriers.
Yeah.
But let's find out what this price is.
Round the world.
$2,800.
What?
$2,800. If you're going to buy a ticket from here to Australia, it's going to be $1,600 probably.
So $1,200 more, you go around the world.
Yeah.
Now, you don't have to do that all in 1 week, right? You can spread that out.
No, you can do it in 6 months.
Trip Planner. Wow, I wonder if Sarah and Brendan used that. Brendan used that when they were doing their around.
It's called Trip Planner, but the website's Airtrex.
Airtrex.com.
They're based in San Francisco.
Okay, very cool.
I love it. Okay, so if you're going to go to Europe and you're going to be there for more than 21 days, mm-hmm. don't rent a car. Okay. Lease one.
Lease it.
Yes. You get a brand new car every time. You get the one that you picked. You get tax included, which saves you about 18%. You can be 18 years old. Most car rentals, you need to be 23.
Is it less expensive?
It is less expensive when you factor everything else in.
Wow.
But you can travel to 28 different countries and drop off in 36 different locations.
And Renault does this?
Yep.
Wow.
This is EuroDrive, and you can do it from Australia, Canada, U.S. You can't be a European to do this.
Yeah, of course not.
Yes, because
then they would take advantage of this. And this is probably their idea of getting you to like Renault cars, but what the heck? Hey, that's a good deal.
Yeah.
In fact, when I rent a car in France, I rent Renaults, usually.
It's a nice, they have all different sizes, too.
Oh, that's really cool. So that's Renault's own site, EuroDrive.
This is the USA site, but they have one. Just hit EuroDrive and you'll find it.
One more.
Okay. I was in, I was in Rio. I needed some help on
it's
some languages.
Portuguese.
How do you speak Portuguese?
Yeah.
So in London, I was checking out the BBC.com. And they have a whole section on how to speak different languages, 34 different languages, in fact, from Chinese to Portuguese. And you can download it to your MP3.
And you can listen? So you can get
listen.
Pronunciation,
I don't know if we have
right?
audio on this, but you can just...
I don't think we do, but that's still, that's
you
very
can just hit
cool.
Obrigado.
Obrigado.
Means thank you. If you're a woman, you say obrigada.
Obrigada.
No.
That's good. You learned that very quickly.
Yeah.
Did you learn I'm sorry and I'll be out of here in a moment?
I tried.
Johnny, every time you come on, you make me want to travel. Go to johnnyjet.com, and that's the one disclaimer I got to give you. You're going to want to go somewhere as soon as you get there. It's really, really fun. I love seeing you, and don't rack up too many miles this month, okay? He loves to do it. Hey, while we're on the subject, let's talk about getting up close and personal to some tech object. This is a close-up picture that Sean Carruthers took of something. Don't know what it is. Tell you what, stick around. We'll zoom out and find out. The lab continues.